Hi guys, how are you? I hope you are all doing well. This is Somashekar Kalepalli. Welcome to Thermal Wing YouTube channel. In this class, I will explain about thermal radiation and how the thermal radiation is emitted from a body. I will explain in this video. Those who have not subscribed to this channel, first subscribe to this channel for more interesting thermal concepts.
Objects grow hotter, they radiate energy with a shorter wavelength, changing color before our eyes. Watch a flame shift from yellow to blue as it is adjusted to burn hotter. In
Thermal radiation is a type of electromagnetic radiation that is pertinent to heat transfer is known as thermal radiation. Thermal radiation emitted as a result of energy transitions of molecules, atoms, and electrons of a substance. Thermal radiation is also defined as thermal radiation emitted from a material due to the heat of the material. Temperature is a measure of the strength of these activities at the microscopic level. Rate of thermal radiation emission increases with increasing temperature. If a temperature of a material increases, thermal radiation emission also increases. Temperature of the material decreases, thermal radiation emission is also decreases. Thermal radiation is also called as heat radiation. In thermal radiation, thermal energy is converted into electromagnetic energy. Thermal radiation is continuously emitted by all matter whose temperature is above absolute zero, that is 0 Kelvin or minus 273 degrees Celsius. Example, everything around us, such as human body, furniture, walls, sun, constantly emits or absorbs thermal radiation. Observe the diagram of an electromagnetic spectrum. Thermal radiation extends from 0.1 micrometer to 100 micrometers. Radiation emitted by bodies due to their temperature almost entirely into this wavelength range, that is from 0.1 micrometer to 100 micrometer. Observe the portion of the thermal radiation on electromagnetic spectrum. It consists of full of visible light and infrared radiation and the portion of ultraviolet radiation. Repeating, thermal radiation consists of entire visible light and infrared radiation and the portion of ultraviolet radiation. Each one can be explained in detail, that is, what is meant by visible light, what is meant by infrared radiation, and what is meant by ultraviolet radiation can be explained in detail. Visible light is simply the visible portion of the electromagnetic spectrum. Visible light extends from 0.4 micrometer to 0.7 micrometer wavelength on electromagnetic spectrum. Visible light can be able to see by our naked eye. Visible light consists of 0.4 micrometer to 0.76 micrometer wavelength from violet to red.
Though our sun's visible light appears white, it is really the combined light of the individual rainbow colors with wavelengths ranging from violet at 380 nanometers to red at 700 nanometers. Before Isaac Newton's famed experiment in 1665, people thought that a prism somehow colored the sun's white light as it bent and spread a sunbeam. Newton disproved this idea by using two prisms. To show that white light is made up of the bands of colored light, Newton used a second prism to show that the bands of colored light combine to make white light again. Visible light contains important scientific clues that reveal hidden properties.
Wavelength ranges of different colors, violet, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. Violet having lower wavelength, red color having higher wavelength. According to Planck's theory, higher wavelength having lower frequency. Lower wavelength having higher frequency. Violet color is having lower wavelength and it consists of higher frequency, higher energy. Higher wavelength and lower frequency, lower energy when compared to violet color. This is an important concept in competitive point of view also.
Objects grow hotter, they radiate energy with a shorter wavelength, changing color before our eyes. Watch a flame shift from yellow to blue as it is adjusted to burn hotter. In
a body that emits some radiation in the visible range is called a light source. The sun is obviously our primary light source.
Our sun produces more yellow light than any other color because of its surface temperature. If the sun's surface were cooler, say 3000 degrees Celsius, it would look reddish, like the stars Antares and Betelgeuse. If the sun were hotter, say 12,000 degrees Celsius, it would look blue, like the star Rigel.
The electromagnetic radiation emitted by sun is known as solar radiation. Solar radiation is an example of thermal radiation. Solar radiation wavelength band 0.3 to 3 micrometers. Solar radiation consists of visible light, infrared radiation and ultraviolet radiation. Half of solar radiation is visible light. This diagram represents the solar radiation. Solar radiation is an example of thermal radiation. Because of the heat of the sun emits thermal radiation in the form of electromagnetic waves, and these electromagnetic waves travel at the speed of light. Solar radiation reaches on the earth surface in the form of electromagnetic waves at the speed of light. It can travel in vacuum also. Solar radiation consists of three types of radiations: infrared radiation, visible light and ultraviolet radiation. The percentage of infrared radiation in solar radiation is 54.3%. Visible light contribution 38.9%, ultraviolet radiation 6.8%. That is about visible light of thermal radiation. Infrared radiation and ultraviolet radiation of thermal radiation I will explain in next class. If this video is worthy for you, click like button. Subscribe to this channel for more interesting thermal concepts. And what is your favorite color in the visible spectrum? Post in the comment section. Thank you for your patience listening.